Every time there is a mass shooting, all society talks about is guns.
And by the way, Paris is one of the places in the world that's toughest on guns. No protection whatsoever. There was nothing anybody can do.
Immigrants and poor people.
You look at the migration. Now they'll start infiltrating with women and children. Wow, they're all men. And not only are they men, they're young men and they're strong as can be. They're tough looking cookies.
But every single time there is an incident of public violence like this, we also quietly lose more of our rights to privacy and freedom. Politicians every single time blame encryption and privacy for their failure to protect us from violence. Only few pointed out that our governments made deals with the corporations which services we use on daily basis without asking us permission to play God. So I decided I will no longer be silent about this. I have made steps to protect myself and I'm going to share them with you because I'm surprised by how many people think there is no alternative. But it's also necessary to spread this message and make pressure on our governments around the globe. That's the state we have reached. A state when we have to protect ourselves from our own governments. But we can win, because they may have the means, but we have the numbers. Have you ever thought to yourself that it seems like everything is justified in the fight against terrorism? From killing toddlers and grandmas in the Middle East to aggressive corporate censorship of our activities on the internet and social media. I had this thought for a long time. Every time there is a suicide bombing or shooting somewhere in the West, the public reaction always makes this thought more vivid. After the Paris attacks, everything was blamed on Edward Snowden and encryption. Intelligence officials and politicians claimed that the ISIS used encryption even though there was absolutely zero evidence for it. To me, it also looked like media stopped doing journalism for a while. Everything politicians said was taken as a fact. Number of articles appeared repeating the same nonsense about how ISIS may have used PS4 to plot the attack. All the mainstream media joined the fuss even though there was absolutely no evidence for it. It was just a crowd effect that originally started with one Politico article about communication systems through PS4. Yet it's amazing to see what the power of fear can do. I found this ridiculous article on Forbes explaining how an ISIS agent could spell out an attack plan in Super Mario Maker's coins and share it privately with a friend. Or two Call of Duty players could write messages to each other on a wall in a disappearing spray of bullets. Now, I'm trying to imagine this. Yeah, totally legitimate. This is a completely easy and fast process, no problem at all. I think it wouldn't be easier at all to just meet up in person or use whatever else.
Build that wall!
Before, the spying agencies have been lobbying for more snooping powers. So they got them. First they wanted phone records of every citizen around the globe. They then moved to the internet. They demanded browsing history. They got it. They asked for email conversations. They got those as well. Google searches came next, then online orders, bank records, private chats, Skype calls and any other means of electronic communication fell into the dirty hands of perverts who have fetish on snooping on people's private lives. Then they requested backdoors to encrypted devices and software. Hard way or easy way, they eventually got that either. And now what they are asking is what they can do with those data. First, it was all in the name of fighting against terrorism, which proved to be a filthy lie, but that's not surprising from people who get off to privacy of others. The term itself has more than 100 official and academic definitions. Then they silently moved to the goalpost and used their capabilities on war on drugs, which basically is just a politicized waste of taxpayers' money that helps drug cartels stay off the grid, commit organized crimes, and sell drugs without regulation and paying taxes. And today, we are being stripped off our fundamental amendments in the name of fighting against extremism, quite possibly the vaguest term ever created by the pinnacle of human stupidity. The question now isn't whether we are reaching a surveillance state. We are surveillance state already. The question now is, what are they going to be doing with us now that they've got us all bare naked, trapped inside their test tubes to study how we can be of danger to the national security? We know they don't do it to protect us from terrorism, because they admit it, A. Bulk collection doesn't help, If anything, it only makes it harder. B, they have actually prevented zero threats of terrorism. Yet they still keep pushing and asking for more powers, so they must be doing it for something else. It impresses me how much money must go wasted in here. Just the budget of the NSA is $70 billion a year, which is more than the entire defense budget of Russia. FBI now owns a $1 billion facial recognition tool that uses mostly photos from driving licenses. Just one tool that cost $1 billion. And with that tool, they still couldn't prevent Orlando mass shooting, even though Omar Mateen was investigated by FBI and was on their watch list. With all the technology, he still slipped through and killed dozens of people. If you didn't realize, all those money comes from taxpayers. Thinking about this too, there's a way how this thing could be abused. For example, if they had the motivation, they could find a match of your criminal lookalike, which has happened in the past by accident, and get rid of you at any point in time. Privacy is dead. It's gone. But here is how we take it back. By protecting ourselves, by compelling our rigged governments, and by spreading the message, we can still keep the value of privacy alive before it's long forgotten by a new generation who hasn't even lived in a private world. If we prevent that, we will eventually make it happen. We could write internet constitutions of human rights that will fundamentally protect all of our rights online, just like it used to before the era of the internet. We can make the spies to work on warrant basis again. It's necessary to make clear we aren't against spying and don't want an unbreakable encryption, but we are against bulk collection and spying on law-abiding citizens without the warrant, with spying agencies treating us all guilty until proven innocent, with the only problem that in one way or another they can make us all guilty. If you think you can't do anything to protect yourself, don't believe it. I'll give you alternatives on everything on the internet. For email, you shouldn't use anything from Google, Yahoo, Microsoft or giants like this. If you use Gmail, not only does Google or Alphabet, oh god, what a terrible name, sells your private conversations to the NSA, they also trade it to the marketeers. There is a way you can use any service to asymmetrically encrypt all your messages, but you'd have to do it for every email and every recipient individually. Services like ProtonMail have used this same technique but made it invisible for you. So all your emails are encrypted by default, but you don't have to do anything. There is even a great Android and iOS app. It's not perfect, but it's certainly 100 times better than Gmail, and it's a step in the right direction. There is no advertising, and you have a protection against bulk collection. For instant messaging and calling, use Signal from Open Whisper Systems. These guys are absolutely amazing. All messages and calls are end-to-end encrypted. It costs you nothing, and the whole program is open source, which means for you there are no backdoors in it like there could be in WhatsApp, because the code of the app is public, and if it was changed, auditors would have noticed. This tool is literally the best. You should convert all your contacts who are using WhatsApp to this. WhatsApp uses end-to-end encryption as well, but it's closed source and owned by Facebook, which means two things. You have no idea about the backdoors, and since WhatsApp is tied to your phone number, Facebook has all that too. You also have to pay for WhatsApp, while Signal is completely free, functioning thanks to the grants and donations. So tell your friends they don't need to pay $1 a year anymore. I don't recommend using Google Chrome for browsing, because Google knows every site you visit and ties that information to your profile that they make on you. You should use Firefox and take advantage of its privacy add-ons and configuration. First, get Privacy Badger. Facebook, Twitter and Google have been using like and share buttons to track your activity, match it with the identifying cookies on your device and track you even after you log out of their sites. Privacy Badger blocks and deletes all of those and other trackers. You can combine it with Disconnect, which stops trackers from more than 2000 third-party sites and loads your pages 27% faster. It's always nice to overkill, so you can also install Decentralize, which kills any other attempts of tracking you through the web. You can install Microblock or uBlock and not AdBlock, because AdBlock is paid by companies not to block their ads. After that, you should also delete your cookies at every instance, because the websites use cookies to also track your traffic outside their pages. Self-destructing cookies add-on deletes all of those cookies. However, there are some kind of cookies that rise from the dead. They are called zombie cookies or super cookies. These special unkillable cookies links cannot be deleted manually. But fortunately, there is an add-on called Better Privacy that can delete and destroy them after you close your browser. So when you install this add-on and you close the browser, this add-on will eliminate all those zombies and super cookies. Another way websites can track you is to use browser fingerprint. Browser fingerprints combines browser configuration, version of your browser, version of your operating system on your device, type of your device. They can even tell which add-ons and plugins you have installed, which versions of them, and all the other browser configurations that you have installed. And all of this contributes to a very, very unique browser fingerprint that websites can use to identify you every time you visit their website. So we can use random agent spoofer to get one step ahead of these sneaky bastards. Lastly, you can also install HTTPS everywhere, which will encrypt your connection with every major website, making it more secure. This will give you a general protection against web tracking. You should know that there is also your IP address that reveals your identity as well. IP address can be hide only using virtual private network or proxy servers. That's a topic for another discussion. This configuration will protect you from web tracking and from websites to communicate your data from one another, because those data will be deleted right after you finish. In the next instance, they will not know it's you. You should also know that Google can't be trusted with its search engine anymore. Not only it uses all your searches to make a profile on you that's easy to sell to marketers, they also censor your search results based on that profile, your geographic location, and other identifiers. Some personalization might be okay if you want to see content of your interest. But if you are searching for news and facts, you should be given as neutral position as possible. And Google has been proven in the past to censor, for example, extremist search results, which can be interpreted, of course, in various ways. Therefore, I use DuckDuckGo as my primary search engine, which gives me results based on the search terms and not on my profile. It doesn't track anything you do, like Google, which sends the information of your search to the sites you visit during your search. So if you search for poached eggs, the sites you click on will now have all that information in their hands because Google sold it to them. DuckDuckGo doesn't do that, so your search remains yours only.
Your soul is mine.
These tech giants are selling your privacy for peanuts. Facebook sells your entire life on its social media, that is your profile, likes, pics, chats, and everything you do on Facebook, for about $5. That's it. That's how much of an individual value you are worth to them. You could sell a piece of shit for more than this. If you are in the USA, you can turn to the Electronic Frontiers Foundation for appeals to your congressman, but the EU is a little more complicated. It would be great to open a European branch of the EFF, because EU is also equally crucial in modern times of privacy and freedom. So go to EFF.org, hit the Take Action page, and fill any petitions and appeals that you deem are worth your signature. In the EU, there is an individual procedure for every state, so I can't show it to you. But take some action, or at least talk about this. Like sharing this video would also help the case. And me?
Fuck off!
Thank you very much for watching the video. I had a ton of fun and pain making it. I hope you liked it. It turned out to be quite messy at some points, but I really hope that you enjoyed it and it taught you something new. Well, of course, I didn't mention everything that I possibly could. This is just one step out of thousands that you can make to protect yourself from spying on the internet. So feel free to give me your feedback in the comments below and stay tuned for the next video. Bye!